Ladies and gentlemen, I present to you the Jacob Herricks Hour. It's actually the Jacob Herricks 10 minutes or so, because that's how long each reaction takes. But Jacob Herricks made a gift to the channel for me to do 4 more songs. So I'll be doing one a day of what Jacob requested. So I'm getting to this one. And Jacob, just as a heads up, you need to give me another request, because you had requested Matt Kennan's song, The Call, but I'd already done that. I did that actually about 4 years ago or so. And of course, it just emotionally just did a number on me, as it does on everybody. But it was sad, beautiful, poignant, deep, everything. So give me another request. You could leave it here in the comments, or you could email me at rockinthecountry@gmail.com, however you want to get me that request. The comments are fine too, because I see those. But anyway, I am doing a song I don't know. It's Rose Hill's song, The Bible and the Gun. I tried doing Ashley McBride's song, The Bible and a 44, and that was blocked, because all of Ashley's stuff that I do is blocked. Little Dive Bar in Dahlonega was blocked, which sucked, because I loved that video especially. But I was able to upload her version with Eric Church. And then Corb Lund, I did one. It was the Bible, Bible and the on the Dash or something like that. Anyway, this is a Bible and a Gun theme. So interesting. And I've not reacted to Rose Hill. So Jacob, thank you for the gift. And let's see what you've got for us this time around. And this isn't Red Dirt, you said. So we're going to see. Oh, I have a video. Cool. Uh-oh.
He laid them both out on the bed so he could take a look at those 6 blue steel chambers and Mr. Gideon's book. The more he drank, the more his head got filled with doubt. One's a harder road, and one's an easy out. The devil on his shoulder said, just go ahead. But the angel in the room said, you ain't through here yet. And the ticking of the clock pounds like a drum when you're flirting with the trigger to kingdom come.
Nice transition.
You wouldn't want your mama to see you this way, or the preacher that put you underwater that day. One hand holds the key to life, the other holds the darkest lie. And the fool between thinks he has to pick one, the Bible or the gun.
All right. That one line really hit me. It was very well conceived, where he said, the more he drank, the more it filled his head with doubt. That is, wow. That is, I don't want to say spot on, because I don't have direct experience with that, but that is brilliantly put, because it is about doubt. Maybe doubt is the opposite of hope. Yeah, I never thought of it that way. All right, anyway, let's see where else we go. And that transition they made right in there, it was harmonious. It was a really nice tempo change. Nothing shocking about it. And it just kept you in the mood that they said earlier. That's really good.
He was drifting through the pages of his past regrets, till he stumbled on the part about the valley of the shadow of death. And he felt as old as time, but he felt brand new. When he drowned that Smith and Wesson at the bottom of the motel pool. And the ticking of the clock pounds like a drum when you're flirting with the trigger to kingdom come. And you wouldn't want your mama to see you this way, or the preacher that put you underwater that day. One hand holds the key to life, the other holds the darkest lie. And the fool between thinks he has to pick one, the Bible or the gun.
I'm going to point something out here, too. I don't know if this was intentional or not, because not everything is, but a lot more is intentional than meets the eye, ear, or brain. But they brought up the baptism. They didn't use the word baptism, but he said the preacher who, you know, dunked him in the water that day tied into his mother, because when you're a baby, it's common for infant baptism. And that, you know, biblically speaking, whatever emphasis you place on that, represents life. It's a new life. And he threw the gun in the pool in another body of water, and that also represented life because it put the threat away from him of dying. So the water in this is both, in both contexts, is a cleansing element or a just a new life type of element.
Walking on water.
Ah.
Back in Galilee, don't mean near as much to him as a miracle in room 23.
Oh, shit. That's the first time I've seen a mother in a song like this.
Yeah, he walked through the darkest night, and he washed his sins in the morning light. He's thankful for each and every breath that comes. When he looks back on the battle that God won between the Bible and the gun.
Yeah, I'll leave that message up here too. That, yeah, I mean, that's a battle a lot of people wage. It doesn't always get to the point to having a revolver in a hotel room. Yeah, I was discussing is a way better word. Somebody the other day where they were pointing out how all these wars worldwide are fought over religion. And the guy's an atheist, and it doesn't bother me that people are atheists. You know, as long as people are kind and thoughtful, I like having reasonable discussions with people, whether it's political or whatever. It's when people go over the top emotionally, or they just assume that they're right, that I check out. I'm like, dude, like my brain works. I can think, right? I have a process of logic and fairness, and maybe your argument's better than mine, and I'll hear it. But don't come at me like I have no basis for anything I think. That's my general predisposition. So we were talking, and you know, his idea was that all these wars have been fought worldwide over religion. And I said, well, sure enough, but I said, that misses a lot of what you might call silent evidence or the other evidence in a sense. One, I think mankind would battle over, this is what I said. I said, we have wars over geography. They have nothing to do with religion. We have wars over natural resources, whether it's aluminum, whether it's iron, whether it's lithium, whether it's gold, whatever it may be. But I said, what you don't see, and this song represented that in a way, what you also don't see are the number of things that don't happen and haven't happened worldwide because people did get into religion, whatever that religion is. So somebody is a really bad dude and he's murderous, and somehow he gets into Christianity, or he gets into Judaism, or he gets into a mild, whatever, Buddhism, whatever it may be, and he becomes a much more peaceful, calmer person, and he doesn't murder people. Now, that doesn't show up on the stat sheet, so to speak, because it's something that never happened. So what you can look at is things that happened and say, oh, in the name of God, look at how bad religion is because this war in the Middle East is in you know, Israel and Saudi Arabia, whatever. But that misses it. And this is one of those instances where somebody didn't pull the trigger. And in the song, what do you say? Like on one side, the devil or the, you know, was saying, go ahead, do it. And then, but like God wasn't done with him. Something to that effect. Those weren't the words, but that was the impetus. And I love songs like this. You know, I mean, I love a lot of songs. I love laughing songs and stuff when they're well constructed, but this is a good one. And the dude's mother, I mean, that'll get you. Imagine your mom finding you. You know, it's like, oh my God, no. But the dude had the strength to call his mother. I didn't know who he was calling when he called somebody, but he called his mother. And that really says he wants to live. And she, of course, wanted him to live. So I'm not going to rate that one, Jacob. That was a great, great suggestion. I love this kind of, I love depth. I love laughing. I love silliness. I love Josh Ritter racking my brain. I love all that stuff, but this is right in the wheelhouse. I love to feel and think, and this did all of that. So thank you for that, Jacob. Leave your comments, folks, and on to the next song. Have a great day. I'll see you on another video, and keep rocking the country.